Welcome viewers, once again we have sir Rajesh Chaudhary with us. Welcome sir.
नमस्कार।
Today he has chosen a very interesting topic, that is the transit of Jupiter in the Aquarius sign with regard to India's chart, that is Bharat's chart, and what it is going to give to Indians. That's what is the topic today that sir has chosen. Many all of us are very interested whenever a major planet transits and the effects that it will bring in the lives of people. Sir, please.
Yes, Shikhaji, this is going to be a very, in a way, people are expecting a big relief, and it is a big relief because Jupiter's transit into Capricorn makes it weak, because it is its sign of debilitation. And for a very big spell, about 6-7 months, it is coming, digressing from Aquarius to Capricorn, from Capricorn to Aquarius. So its weakness is reduced. And it, for out of 12 months, it is spending more time in Aquarius, in non-debilitation. So that is a good thing. But how it is panning out in India's horoscope, let us see whether it is going to give any relief or some issues are going to be there. So here we see the India's chart, and this is on the bottom right. This is the current transit on 26th of March 2021 at this point of time. So currently, if we see, Jupiter is at 27 degrees in Capricorn.
Right.
And Mars and Rahu are in conjunction here. And Sun and Venus are in conjunction in 11th. So this is a purely transit analysis without any interference of natal chart of India, that Mangal Rahu are close. And Mangal Rahu are close and Sun and Venus are close. So Mangal, Mars is the lord of 12th house. And Mars, and it is in almost exact conjunction with Rahu till 31st of March.
Okay.
And this was brought out many weeks before on our group and list, that this combination is going to give severely negative events of sudden violent nature. And over the past few days and even in next few days, more spikes of corona patients are there. And today I was listening to the news channels that in Mumbai, there was a big fire in a corona hospital,
yes,
in which 10 or 15 people died.
Yes.
So Mars and Rahu, that is a kind of explosive situation. And the good thing is, out of this affliction, is that it is, Mars is not retrograde and Mars is not traveling on this degree for long. This is almost its natural speed, and it is separating out quickly. So in another 4-5 days, this conjunction is going to be over, and it is not going to cause a catastrophic damage. And it is happening in the sign Taurus, which is a benefic house for India. It is the ascendant. Another conjunction which is these days going on is this Sun and Venus. This conjunction is going to last long. This is going to be there well within the April. And when Sun and Venus are together, Sun rules 4th house of Indian independence chart, and Venus is the ruler of 6th house. Multrikona sign is in the 6th house, though the non-Multrikona sign is the ascendant, but still it gives more results like 6th house, a malefic nature is more pronounced when it is coming in contact with natal points or planets. So unrest, harm to domestic harmony, and the peace of the country is disturbed due to this conjunction. But still, both these are slow-moving planets. By chance, sometimes happen that they start traveling at same speed, like people are taking a walk in a park, holding hands. So even slow-moving planets transit without being stationary, sometimes take longer to separate. So it is here Venus, though it is in exaltation sign, but it remains combust with for sun. A very big spell, because it is in conjunction with Sun. So diseases are not protected. When sixth house Lord is weak in such state that it is combust for long, the protection from diseases is missing. If you remember, before Venus got combust and came close to Sun, the level of the number of cases being reported was very less. But as soon as this conjunction started, the number of cases suddenly started taking a spike. Even though we have vaccinated now more than 5 crore people in India. Yes. Then also, now even vaccinated people are sometimes reporting. So this is these are the two current transit phenomena. But now we will talk about Jupiter. So Jupiter is at 27 degrees in Capricorn, and on 7th of April, it transits to
Aquarius.
Aquarius. We see April 7th. So it comes to Aquarius. Now, when Jupiter comes to Aquarius, it's the Lord of 8th house for India. And when it was weak in Capricorn due to debilitation, it was not protecting the loss of life and sudden incidents. So hurdles were there, loss of life was there, but now when it moves out of debilitation, it becomes stronger here. So it is expected that some relief is there. But unfortunately, that relief is going to be short-lived, because Jupiter is going to travel very fast, on a fast speed, and it reaches around 6 degrees on 15th of May. So 15th of May, Jupiter, let us put it here. This is transit Jupiter, 6 degrees. So transit Jupiter is 6 degrees here. So what it means for India? It means that Jupiter is going to afflict Mars by fifth aspect.
12th Lord.
12th Lord Mars. 12th Lord Mars, the natal Mars is placed in the second house, and it is under exact affliction of transit Jupiter here by fifth aspect. And the more disturbing thing is that India's MEP, the most effective point or the ascending degrees, is 745. And 745 Mars, natal Mars, is placed close to that. So that is the primary reason of disturbance of domestic harmony time and again here. And this Jupiter is going to be stationary at around this degree only. Because if we see, from June, say 15th of June, Jupiter is at 7 degrees, 759. So up to middle of July, Jupiter remains at 7 degrees only. So for 15th of May to middle of say end of July or middle of August, it remains quite close to
Mars
and keeps on afflicting the MEP of India star.
Right.
So it impacts fifth house. Fifth aspect is on second house.
Mm-hmm.
Exact seventh aspect is on fourth house and
sixth
house. So all three houses are being afflicted by transit Jupiter, and it is simultaneously afflicting Mars also, natal Mars. Okay. So that is a very going to be a very negative and eventful period for India, because here this house, sixth house, rules diseases. So it, when the Jupiter being the lord of eighth house is afflicting sixth house of diseases, so diseases result in more deaths, loss of life is more. Then Jupiter afflicts fourth house, so the unrest, the mental peace, domestic harmony, the agriculture sector, the all the things which are ruled by fourth house, these because in mundane astrology each house rules so many aspects.
Correct.
So I will share a link with you which tabulates all the aspects which are ruled in mundane chart. So one can go through that to make out what is going to be the color.
Okay.
Because eighth lord, when eighth lord and fourth lord are in eighth lord, fourth lord, or eighth house and fourth house are in some kind of close conjunction, you will find natural disasters, mass deaths, big major incidents catching the attention of country. Are there. And 12th house is the house of losses, expenses, hospitalization. So that planet is also going to come under the affliction of transit Jupiter for about 2.5 months. So the summer and rainy season is going to be problematic for health, for finances, for stock markets, for you will see that many scandals come to light during this spell. More NPAs are discovered, and more finances, basically financials are impacted more. And because houses involved are second, fourth and sixth, so they involve masses. It's not that a particular person or a very small class of person is impacted. It engulfs almost all strata of society. Because cohesiveness is disturbed, and even the status of the country takes a beating. Here the judiciary also finds itself overactive. You will find judiciary in the overdrive. When Jupiter is dominating 10th house for Taurians and dominating second house also, the role of judiciary suddenly becomes very important. They start taking cognizance of almost all matters and start giving their opinions. You will find them, otherwise they are not interested in those things, but they suddenly become more active. So that is Jupiter's power. It is trying to be in all those that period of turmoil. It tries to bring a aspect of justice and controlling the things by law. So that is Jupiter's general signification. Whether it is no doubt it is a first rate malefic for Taurus, but still Jupiter remains the ruler of judiciary, ruler of justice, fairness. So those qualities also come hand in hand. They try to balance out the negative aspects which are being caused here. But still, since the transit is long, from middle of May to almost first week of August, so it going to be a troublesome period. And during this spell, you will see that Rahu Ketu are stationary at 16 something. Okay. 16 degrees, 16 and a half. So 16 and a half, when they become stationary, so transit Ketu aspects natal Mercury also.
Yes.
So that impact is not going to be very close, because it is almost 3 degree difference is there.
Okay.
So, but still, lots of children, maybe you will hear lots of children are involved in some tragedies or some problems, because Ketu gives problems of sudden and severe nature, accident kind of,
yes,
explosive things. So that, and Mercury rules fifth house for India. So natal Mercury, when it is in aspect of transit Ketu for long time, so some incidents can be there. But still, the good thing for India's Mercury is that it is having a reasonable strength. It is not combust. It is placed in third house, which is ruled by Moon, and Moon is also placed there. So its dispositor is also in a good shape, in almost you can say fairly good strength. So it is having some inherent strength, which will hold for it. But these two combinations of Jupiter Mars on the MEP, they are going to be a bit difficult.
Perfect, sir. So what do you think is, when do we have relief from Corona?
Relief from?
From Corona,
you will find that that relief is in the waves. Like when whole world was witnessing surge, India was almost okay.
Okay.
Then again, whenever, if you analyze the past 1.5 years of Corona, or approximately 1 year, you will find whenever Rahu Ketu got stationary,
right,
there was a big spike. And now also this spike is coming because of that Sun-Venus conjunction. And as soon as this Sun-Venus conjunction gets over, this Jupiter will come here. So relief from Corona, when this Jupiter travels out of 7 degrees, it out by end of August, it will be again a big dip, and big relief would be there.
Okay, sir, thank you very much. Everyone just wants one question answered: when are we going to stop seeing Corona as a a major, you can say, it has really now become more than 1 year. It started in
more
November.
Than 1 year. The planetary influences are giving you very good guidance, but that goes hand in hand with the policies of the government. Government policies of now, when from 1st of April they have started giving vaccines for 45 plus people.
Correct.
And this without any other clause. So if this vaccination drive is done in full steam, so you will find in another 2-3 months time, during this Jupiter period only, after that you will find a significant drop. Because up to now, who was vaccinated? Vaccinated people are either armed forces or doctors or frontline workers or senior citizens.
Correct.
And senior citizens are not on the move. They are in homes.
Correct.
On the move is the population between 40 to 55 or 35 to 55. And they were not provided an opportunity to get vaccinated at their will.
Correct.
Now, when that thing is coming, so you will find that is effective. That will bring results. But that it will not, it is because India has a huge population, and most of the people you will find in this age group. So it is going to take many months for big chunk to get vaccinated, about 30-40% of the persons. So any vaccination drive can be successful when at least 25-30% of the target is achieved. Then it starts showing results. So hopefully this by this year end, because if you analyze a transit, the next station of Rahu, say when it after 16 degrees, it again gets stationary at during November at 7 degrees. So at 7 degrees, again, the India's natal Rahu Ketu axis is at 544. So again, in the last quarter of the year, you will find again some kind of issue. After that, it moves out. So it is going to be in bits and pieces, but we are on a recovery path, because overall strength, if you see, India is currently under the subperiod of Saturn. And Saturn is placed in the third house. And in transit, Saturn is in the ninth house. So ninth house, Saturn is not going to be afflicted by natal Rahu or natal Mars at all. The only shortcoming for Saturn this year is that transit Rahu Ketu axis is running quite close.
Right.
For about 2 months, it comes in close conjunction. But otherwise, this Saturn is gaining strength day by day. Mm-hmm. And the subperiod of Saturn will definitely save us.
Great,
Like we in earlier video, we saw that impact of Saturn in that example.
Yes, sir.
Exactly same thing happened with India's chart. Like I will just show you that thing. Clear all drawings. When Saturn was in 2020. Saturn, India's subperiod of Saturn started on December 19. And in 2020, September 20, Saturn remained for whole year at about 1 degree. Last 6 months, it was at 1 degree. So it remained under the, where is this arrow? It remained under the influence of natal Rahu for most of the time. If you see transit of Saturn during 2020, it remained, though it came out of 8th house, it could have been very good. But for whole first year, it remained under the influence of natal Rahu. So that did not allow Saturn to work at all. And out of that 6 months, it was at around 1 degrees. So it had no inherent strength. It was in utter infancy. So now things are going to be very different, because Saturn is going to remain in the band of 12 degrees to 19 degrees throughout this year. So it is in the young age, and it will withstand the influence of Venus or transit Rahu. So it is going to be much positive that way. That's all.
Very interesting, sir. Very different and very interesting way of analyzing. This is really a beautiful system. But we need to go and work, because it is not very easy. We really need to sit with
One needs to practice.
Yeah.
The best thing I tell my students is that first thing in the morning when you open your eyes, remember God. And first thing I do is on my phone, I click on the Jyotish app and see where the planets are in transit. So when you start analyzing each and every small incident, if you in your chart or in country's chart, if you start finding out the reasons why this thing happened today with me, or why this thing is happening, any major incidents of national importance. So if you keep on working on that on the your own chart or net or country's chart, you become master in transit analysis in say about 1 year, because most of the combinations and permutations you come to know.
Yeah, we really need to work, and that is the hardest part. We will sit and learn whatever is being taught, but we will never open charts or practice on it. That is a drawback that most of us have, even me. So let us work, all of us. Sir has given us a beautiful theory. Please go and work. Check this out, what sir has said today. It was very interesting, and why we are facing this corona, exactly what is happening, sir has been telling us. One before video also, sir had done an analysis on a corona patient. So you all can also do this, go and check that out, check that video out, and combine it with this video of India, and let's see this corona, how it pans out in India according to the transit of planets. Sir, thank you very much. Very interesting session.
Thank you.
We are going to have a webinar conducted by sir. It is a very important webinar, and he is going to teach us how to do career guidance for children. That is the main important topic. Of course, there is a topic of childbirth and autism and everything. Please go and check out the details on my Facebook and YouTube and Instagram, everywhere. Thank you very much.
Namaste.
Namaste, sir.